Thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you to the organizers for giving me the opportunity. And I will talk of the topic of my thesis. It concerns geometric mechanics, more particularly non-holonomic systems, that is, mechanical systems with constraints in the velocities. So we will study this mechanical system, which consists of a ball rolling inside a surface of revolution. Here, there are the data of the ball is homogeneous, so the inertia tensor is scalar. And first, the system has holonomic constraints given by the fact that the center of mass of the ball is constrained to lie in the surface. So, and moreover, the system has non-holonomic constraints because the ball is rolling, so if the ball is have a velocity, linear velocity, then as the ball is rolling, then there is an angular velocity. So the angular velocity is tied to the linear velocity. The configuration of the space is the system is described by five parameters, the coordinates of the center of mass, R2, and an orthogonal matrix, SO3, indicating the orientation of the ball. The system has symmetries, one spatial symmetry, S1, given by, because the surface is of revolution, and another symmetry, SO3, because the ball is homogeneous. So it doesn't have a privileged axis of inertia. So this system was studied since the work of Rhodes, who already did found first integrals for the system. Then Hermans studies his PhD in the system, studying the structure of the coordinates in the reduced system. He shows that the orbits in the reduced system are periodic or fixed points. Senkov study stability of the problem. Borisov, Kilifin, and Mamaev showed that in the quotient space, there is a Poisson structure. But the methods they used were not very geometric. And we will show how to find this Poisson structure from a geometric point of view. So there are also these two works of Ramos and Faso, Jacobes, and Sonetto, who explained better the Poisson structure found by Borisov, Killin, and Mamaev. Okay, the system geometrically is modeled by an almost Poisson manifold, and it's really almost because the characteristic distribution of the bi vector is not integrable. Anyway, it describes the dynamics. We can find a vector field describing the dynamics using a Hamiltonian. Having a Hamiltonian, we compute the vector field. And we have also equations of motions of integral, of observables here, using the bracket. The problem is that as the bi vector is not Poisson, the equations of motion are not Hamiltonian. But the system has symmetries. And the symmetries preserves the Hamiltonian and also the bi vector. So we can reduce the system. And the question is to see if the reduced system is Poisson, if the reduced equations of motion are Hamiltonian. So it's always possible to reduce under the conditions here. And we want to see if this equation is Hamiltonian or if the reduced bracket is Poisson. So the method here gauge transformations were already applied in other mechanical systems. Last year, Paola Balseiro, Luis García Naranjo, and James Montaldi showed the Hamiltonization of a solid of revolution rolling in a plane. Maybe here it's important to stress that the main example here is the Chaplygin ball. This is a non-homogeneous ball rolling in a plane. This was studied already in the beginning of the 20th century and only showed the Hamiltonian structure 100 years later, no? By Borisov and Mamaev. Okay, is a mechanical system, so it is described by a configuration space, Q, a Lagrangian, and a distribution of permitted velocities, which is non-integrable. Recall that we have this, the constraints between the velocities, linear velocities and angular velocities, so we have here a non-integrable distribution. In the Hamiltonian side, we can find the manifold, the constraint manifold. The Hamiltonian is defined in the standard way, only we restrict, we restrict to the manifold M. The manifold M is found by Legendre transformation of D. And it is a soft manifold of the cotangent bundle here. And now we have to find which is the bivector. Now the bivector is described by a distribution in the manifold M, which is found using the distribution D, which is a distribution in Q. This distribution is non-integrable, and a two section on this distribution, which is this omega C. The construction is standard. We start with a canonical two section. We restrict to M, which is a subset of T star Q, and then we can evaluate only in vectors belonging to the distribution C. So it was shown by Bates and Snetnicki that this two section is non-degenerate. That is, it gives a one-to-one correspondence between vectors here and one forms here. So we can define this bivector. For a one form, we have the image, a vector. And this bivector has a characteristic distribution, which is C, is non-integrable. So Jacobi identity can't be verified. It describes the dynamics. We can compute the vector field and the evolution of operators. But the important thing is that it's not the characteristic distribution is not integrable, because C is not integrable. The system has symmetries. We will suppose that we have a group acting properly on the manifold, not necessarily freely. And we take the lift of the action to the tangent space and the cotangent space, and we get a symmetry of the non-holonomic system. That is, the group acts on the manifold M, H is invariant, G invariant, and the bivector is also G invariant. Now, the quotient space is not necessarily a manifold, but since the action is proper, it can be understood as a stratified space and a differential space structure. That is, we define a set of smooth functions on this quotient space and this topological space. As we say that the smooth functions in this space are the G invariant functions on the space M. And since the action is not proper, also the vertical space, the orbits have not the same dimension at each point. Now, we can find the reduced bivector in the reduced bracket in the quotient space, because the bracket is of G invariant functions is G invariant. So we can define this bracket in the quotient space. This reduced bracket is a priori almost Poisson. But perhaps, maybe it could have integrable characteristic distribution, or maybe could be Poisson. And we want to see what happens in our mechanical system. The reduced dynamics, we use the reduced Hamiltonian because it's G invariant, and we use the reduced bracket, and we get the reduced dynamics in the standard way. Is it Hamiltonian? Is the question. So for our mechanical system, the constraints are given by this vector equation from physics. The omega is the angular velocity, and v is the linear velocity of the center of mass. So in our coordinates, this vector equation is written at those equations for the velocities and the omega, the angular velocities. From these equations, we can write one forms, and the distribution D of constraints is the common kernel of the two distributions. So it is shown here. The explicit values here are not very important, but it is three-dimensional, it is of rank 3. We complete a basis from using this basis of D, we complete to a basis of TQ using this Z1 and Z2, these other vectors. We compute the canonical basis of T star Q. So having this basis, we can compute the Liouville 1 form, the canonical 2 form. Also, by Legendre transformation, we can compute the image of D and get the constraint manifold. This is this eight-dimensional manifold. Here we have 10 parameters. G is three-dimensional. But the last two ones, the last ones are dependent. So we have eight parameters. We know to compute how to compute the omega section, the omega c section from as I explained it, the Liouville 1 form, and the, also we know how is the diffusion c. So we are ready to compute the bivector field. The expression is a bit complicated, but it is explicitly found here.
Can you show again the previous slide?
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, this is the non-holonomic bivector. We compute the Hamiltonian. And having the Hamiltonian, we compute the dynamics. And this complicated expression. And of course, it's not Hamiltonian. This dynamics is not Hamiltonian because the bracket is not Poisson. Now, we will perform the reduction by the symmetry. The group acts properly. Here, how the group acts in the coordinates of M. But in fact, the action is not free. There are points we can see here. If we compute the vertical space, we see that when x, y is zero and the momenta px and py are zero, the rank of the vertical space is not 4, it's 3. So in that point, which corresponds a configuration where the ball is in the bottom of the surface, it doesn't have velocity, linear velocity, but it's in the bottom and only can spin. So this is those are points which have an isotropy group, non-trivial isotropy group. The isotropy group is S1 for those points, and all the other points have trivial isotropy. It's a differential space, as we explained. It's a sub-Cartesian space, so we can define vector fields on it. We can always define derivations, but the derivations can be integrated local one-parameter diffeomorphisms, so we have vector fields on those spaces. Since the action is proper, the space is stratified by orbit type. This is classical for proper actions. And the vector fields preserve the strata of the stratification, and they induce smooth vector fields on each stratum. So now we perform the reduction. First, the reduction by SO3 is free. So the quotient is a manifold given by these five parameters. The action by SO3, by S1 is not free. This is this more or less classical action of a rotation matrix in R4. And this is, it's described using invariant polynomials. So there is a basis of invariant polynomials. Here there are five polynomials. And the quotient is, so this the parameters here, the coordinates verify this one algebraic equation. So this is a semi-algebraic subset. Semi, because there are also some inequalities. The one-dimensional stratum, as we said, the ball only is spinning in the bottom of the surface, corresponds when the first four are zero, And the complementary is a regular manifold, four-dimensional manifold given here. We will see that the reduced bracket is not Poisson. For that, we will use a result proved by Paola Balseiro. Yes?
What's the regular stratum if you move it to? Is it R4? Do you know what manifold that is?
Diffeomorphically, you know. Yeah. You mean.
Is it compact? Not compact, that's depending on the surface.
Is. Yeah. I don't have here. Yes, I was not interested in the topology of the space. As far as I remember, this MG is a cone on a sphere. So S2 with rays R2, and from that space we are eliminating this space. I don't have an answer here. Sorry, but I will think about that. So the reduced bracket is not Poisson. We use this formula of the Jacobiator for the reduced bracket, which implies the computing, the knowing of a tree form here, of a G-invariant tree form. And for that, for compute this G-invariant tree form, we need to choose a G-invariant complement to the constraints. So from C, we find a vertical G-invariant complement such that we get the total tangent space of M. And so we can compute if this term, by instance, is zero for any G-invariant, for any basic functions, then the bracket will be Poisson. This is one way, natural way to show. So I don't have time here to explain the construction of the tree form, but yes, this is our tool. In our mechanical example, we found a distribution W which verifies the conditions before. And this is vertical and G invariant. So we verify that we have this complement W. And we applied the theorem before, and we get that the reduced bracket is not Poisson. That is, we choose the W, we compute the G invariant tree form, because this is G invariant, and we find some polynomials where the Jacobiator is not zero. Okay, so the reduced space is not Poisson, but what we can't do now is to deform the bivector structure here using a two-form. This is a standard way to deform bivectors, and we'll deform it using a G-invariant two-form B and get another bracket here. Also, this is G-invariant, and we can perform the reduction, and then we get here in M over G this bracket, and we can verify if this bracket is Poisson. We have here all family for B, for each B which verifies some conditions. We can get here many Poisson brackets, and maybe some of ones verify that they are Poisson after reduction. The properties of those reduced brackets could be very different, the integrability properties. So here I only recall this standard construction of gauge transformations. We add to our two section omega c, we add a two form b, such that it continues to be non-degenerate. So if this is non-degenerate, we have the one-to-one correspondence between vectors and forms, and we can define our new bivector pi b. And we use it the same distribution c. So the characteristic distribution of the new bivector is also c, but the section has changed. But in applications in mechanical systems, we also need that the dynamics could be preserved, should be preserved. So we want that, that the vector field is the same for the new Bay vector. And so this gives this new condition for the two form B. So this is a dynamical gauge transformation. How to find the B? That is now the question. The idea to find the B will be using first integrals of the system, a special kind of first integrals, knowing horizontal gauge momentum. So those are first integrals such that they are computed from the non-holonomic moment map. So the non-holonomic moment map is like the moment map, but here we don't have all G star. We can only do the pairing with a subspace. On each point, we get here a subspace of G star, and we use those sections to compute the functions here using the formula of the momentum map. And those are the horizontal gauge momenta, first integrals, because the system is non-holonomic. This expression is not necessarily a first integral. So we impose that to be first integral and also be sections of GS. Those are the horizontal gauge momenta. And now, what we want? We want that the Hamiltonian vector field of the horizontal gauge momenta here, using our Bay vector, should be the infinitesimal generator of the section. Recall that the horizontal gauge momenta are defined using a section. So this section generates a field. And we want that these two fields be the same. Why? Because if these horizontal gauge momenta are G invariant, the reduced functions in the quotient are Casimirs of the reduced bracket. This is an easy computation. So we get Casimirs if we have this condition. Okay, and this gives us condition for the two form B. So if we know horizontal gauge momenta here, and we know the section which generates the horizontal gauge momenta, we can compute this one form. It is explicit, we compute them. And if B verifies this expression, then we will get what we want there. So if we write B in local coordinates, we will get B with some coefficients. And writing the equation, we will get conditions on the coefficients. And if we know enough quantity of gauge momenta, we will be able to find unique B, maybe, at least one. Now, there is this proposition who says that if we have, maybe one way to understand the proposition here is, if we have some functions which, after reduction, become Casimirs, yeah, because these vector fields are in S, so are also in V, so the reduction is a Casimir by the lemma before. If we have a number of Casimirs where the number of Casimirs is equal to the rank of the distribution S of S, then the characteristic distribution of the reduced bracket is involutive. So if it is regular, being involutive by Frobenius, it is integrable. And then the reduced bracket will be twisted Poisson. And the almost symplectic leaves of the twisted Poisson structure are the common level sets of the Casimirs. So the idea is to find enough Casimirs such that the quantity of Casimirs should be equal to the rank of S, and we get twisted Poisson. We apply the method to our system. The B having the conditions we want is written in our basis this way. So we have three unknowns, three functions to found, A, B, and C. Yes, those are the conditions. How to find the B? We know two first integrals. The first integrals are horizontal gauge momenta, so we find the sections corresponding to the first integrals, and we compute lambda 1 and lambda 2 before. So now we know these two, lambda 1 and lambda 2 are one forms. So we have equation, system of equations for the coefficients A, B, and C here. We know lambda, we know those fields, and also the dynamical condition. In fact, the system of equation always admits a solution, at least one solution. And in the particular case, which is the case of our example, where the rank of D minus the rank of S is 1, in that case, the B is unique. So the first two conditions induce a unique B, and it automatically verifies the dynamical condition. So for our example, it was enough to find A, B, and C using the first two conditions. And we found the gauge transformation, the two-form, the G-invariant two-form here. Having the B, we can compute the omega C plus B, then the bivector, pi B. B is G invariant, so G is also a symmetry of the non-holonomic system with the bivector pi B. We reduce the system, and we compute the reduced bracket as usual. And we show that the reduced bracket is Poisson. We can show it by two arguments. One, using the proposition before, because we know that the system has two Casimirs. So and the rank of S is 2, so the reduced bracket, since it is regular, the characteristic distribution is regular, we get that the reduced bracket is twisted Poisson. But the quotient space is four-dimensional, and the ellipse are two-dimensional, so it is automatically Poisson. Well, the other argument, we can use the Jacobiator formula before and verify that this Jacobiator is zero, evaluating on all the combinations of G-invariant polynomials that we know explicitly. So the conclusion is this one. We started with a non-holonomic bracket having non-integrable distribution. We verified that the reduced bracket is not Poisson, was not Poisson. We found a two-form, a gauge transformation, having this good property that the vector field corresponding to the first integrals are these infinitesimal generators. So performing the reduction, we get Casimirs, we got Casimirs, and the reduced bracket now is Poisson, and then the equations of motion, the reduced equation of motion, are Hamiltonian. Thank you very much.